Hello, my name is Marloes Mul and I'm an Associate Professor of Water Resources Management at IHE Delft. In this presentation, I will be discussing our initial results of the quality assessment of the WaPOR version 3 data. The quality assessments of the WaPOR data are an integral part of the quality assurance of the WaPOR data. Over the years, several quality assessments have been implemented to evaluate the WaPOR data and to inform improvements to be made to the next version of the data. This presentation details the quality assessment done by IHE Delft on the latest version of WaPOR, namely version 3. Although version 3 is now globally available, the analysis are focused on Africa and the Near East with a time frame of 2018 to 2022, as these are the spatial and temporal extents where version 2 and version 3 overlap. The quality assessment has two components, evaluating the climate input data and evaluating the WaPOR layers. In this presentation, I will focus only on the quality of the WaPOR layers. Some of the major changes from version 2 to version 3 comprise of the changes in the input data, both climate and land surface data, and further parameterization and improving data processing, gap filling and smoothening procedures. A separate quality assessment was also done on the climate input data, comparing the different climatic input data used in the WaPOR data, but will not be further discussed here. There are various types of validations which we implemented in this quality assessment. First, we compare the data with other spatial data products or values from literature. These analyses focus on spatial variability and general trends. For qualitative point validation, we evaluated the WaPOR data against data from climate stations for the reference evapotranspiration and eddy covariance and surface renewal stations for validating the actual evapotranspiration and interception. In addition, we compared various data sources with auxiliary data, meaning WaPOR data was used to estimate other parameters that were then checked against observations, such as yield or a combination of observed data products were used to estimate a WaPOR variable, such as using the water balance approach with data from precipitation and discharge to estimate the actual evapotranspiration. We also performed several plausibility checks using zonal statistics on the different land cover classes we obtained from the WaPOR data. Finally, we repeated some analysis done in journal publications to evaluate the improvements of WaPOR version 3, in particular related to the conservative relationship of water productivity. The first layer to be evaluated was the reference evapotranspiration. We compared the WaPOR version 2 RET data based on GEOS-5 and MSG data with the FAO AG-ERA RET data, which as the name indicates is based on the AG-ERA 5 reanalysis dataset. As you can see, the overall mean value of the RET for the two products for the reference year 2022 are very similar. However, the map in the top right corner shows that spatially there are quite some differences, with the Congo forest showing significant increase and the transition zone in the Sahel belt in West Africa and Southern Africa showing quite some reduction. When comparing this with the changes of five climatic input dataset, namely air temperature, wind speed, vapor pressure, air pressure and radiation, there's some agreement in areas with increasing of the variables in blue, also appearing the higher ET values, RET values, and the areas with many decreasing variables also showing decrease in RET. The comparison with over 100 climatic station data from the TAMO network with stations in Ghana, Tanzania, Kenya and South Africa shows that the WaPOR version 2 RET data has a better correlation with the station data compared to the AG-ERA 5 RET data. But in all other performance indicators, including the root mean square error and bias, the FAO RET AG-ERA 5 data performs better. Overall, both datasets show similar validation against the station data. The comparison was also implemented in previous quality assessment reports and utilized the concept of the water balance to estimate actual evapotranspiration and interception from precipitation and observed discharge. For this analysis, we utilized precipitation data from the CHIRPS dataset and discharge data from the Global Runoff Data Center. We were only interested for this comparison for stations within Africa that contained data after 2018. Unfortunately, only 10 stations fitted that description, mostly located in Southern Africa. The analysis showed that the WaPOR version 3 data and SABOP are the best at closing the water balance for the selected basins and much better than MODIS, GLEAM or GL does. A further comparison was done using a recently published dataset of AETI derived from a combination of different precipitation, storage and runoff dataset applied to 24 basins in Africa. The comparisons of the median of the ET water balance dataset with the WaPOR dataset for each of the river basin is represented in this slide. It showed a slight to significant positive bias for almost all basins in Central and Southern Africa, and a slight significant negative bias of more than 25% in the basins in West Africa. The overall annual comparison per basin shows a good correlation with the mean ET water balance. Focusing more on specific basins and the interseasonal variability, with the blue shaded area representing the 5th to 95th percentile of the dataset, it shows the version 3 data is closer to the median value represented by the dark blue line. However, it does show that some of the basins have problems to follow the seasonal pattern of the other datasets. The validation against station data was done for 13 stations located in South Africa and Senegal. An example for each country is provided here. The combination of performance matrix shown in the diagram illustrates that the performance for version 3 is better in the Senegal case study, closer to the black star shown here. And for the station in South Africa, the two data sets are very similar, so version 2 and version 3, and both show a good correlation with the observed data. The higher resolution is slightly worse than the level 1 data in this case. The overall statistics of the analysis show that the WaPOR data has good correlation with the station data. When the station data is close for the energy balance, the bias is much better. For the surface renewal station, which already considers the closing of the energy balance, the R-square and bias are already very good. One of the main complaints of the WaPOR data was the ability for the data to represent accurately irrigated areas surrounded by a desert landscape. The map shows some center pivots in the desert in southern Egypt where groundwater is pumped to irrigate potatoes. The difference between the WaPOR version 2 data and the WaPOR version 3 data for level 2, 100 meter resolution, is clear. The new WaPOR version is better at differentiating the desert areas and the irrigated areas due to the improved LST downscaling approach. The graph shows the temporal AETI of the cropping season for version 3, represented by the green line, following the gray line representing the crop water requirement. The orange line representing the version 2 data doesn't follow the same pattern. In addition, you see here two graphs representing a crop coefficient calculated by dividing AETI over the reference ET during the cropping season in Egypt for winter wheat. In addition, the in-situ measurement for actual ET is included in the dark blue line. For both seasons, the estimated ET is below the crop coefficient curve, indicating suboptimal conditions. The actual ET estimates are all in the right order of magnitude, with in the first season a slight underestimation of actual ET and in the second season a slight overestimation. The maps of WaPOR interception, transpiration and evaporation data are presented here. The maps show a very low value of interception of less than 10 mm per year at the continental level. Transpiration seems to be related to vegetation cover, which is logical. Similarly, the evaporation shows high values over the Rift Valley lakes in East Africa. A comparison with the global data estimates in percentage of total ET shows that the WaPOR ET estimates for interception are significantly lower than expected and than other global products. Similarly, the transpiration and evaporation components are therefore slightly on the higher side, but there's also significant variation between the different products. The zonal statistics for the different products of evapotranspiration per land cover category shows good patterns. High values for interception are observed for the natural vegetation, which is logical, and high transpiration is observed in the categories with vegetation, such as natural vegetation or trees and cropland. On the other hand, the high transpiration value for water is a bit suspect, but can be explained by the fact that this category also includes wetlands, which often have vegetation as well. High evaporation in this class is also logical. The ratio of the different WaPOR layers also provide some additional information about the plausibility of the data. One thing that stands out is the relatively low AETI of water, as it's only 60% of the reference evapotranspiration, and the expectation is that it should have been closer to 1. Similarly, the transpiration component shows two high values in these indices. On the other hand, the ratio of transpiration in the land cover class with high vegetation shows realistic values. Finally, the analysis of water yield, defined as the precipitation minus the actual evapotranspiration, in the different land cover classes shows that water and irrigated agriculture are water-consuming land cover classes, which makes sense. Although the water land cover class was expected to consume more water, all other land cover classes generate water with relatively high runoff coefficients varying from 22% to 56%, even in areas where little to no runoff is expected, such as bare soil and sparse vegetation. The last layer evaluated is the net primary production layer. Here also high values are observed in land cover classes with vegetations, such as natural vegetation and cropland. To compare the natural net primary production with observations, the NPP for known crop types was converted using these two equations, using crop parameters from literature such as harvest index, moisture content of the crop, and crop type conversion factors for C4 crop. Here we present the yield comparison for a sugarcane estate in Mozambique. This case was also featured in several journal publications where WaPOR analysis were applied. The analysis here present two seasons and for three different irrigation systems, sprinkler, furrow, and center pivots. The analysis were done using level 2 data, meaning 100 meter resolution, the highest resolution available in this area. For each field, the harvest date was available and the harvest date of the preceding season was used as a starting date, so each field had their own cropping season. Even though the correlation is low, 57% of the field in 2019 and 35% in 2020 fall within the 20% range, indicated in the shaded area. The WaPOR version 3 data appears to overestimate, particularly when yields are low, such as for irrigated fields by furrow, and also more so for the fields for the season of 2020. This could indicate a certain stress factor that's not adequately based on the presented analysis, we draw the following preliminary conclusions. For the reference ET, both the reference ET derived from GEOS 5 and Ag Era 5 show very similar results and perform well against station data. It appears the difference in the climate input data are the main cause of the spatial difference of the RET data product. Regarding the actual evapotranspiration data, WaPOR version 3 and SEBOB are the best at closing the water balance for selected basin at annual scale. However, for the monthly time scale, the results vary per basin and in some cases is unable to capture the seasonality. Both WaPOR versions show good correlation with eddy covariance station, but it should be noted that all the stations in Africa are located in shrubland and grassland. The WaPOR version 3 data has improved significantly in estimating AETI in irrigated areas surrounded by desert areas. However, in some other areas, we observe that WaPOR in well-managed croplands is below the crop water requirement, although it does follow the observed data. Finally, we found that the WaPOR AETI data for water bodies is on the low side. The conclusions related to the split of AETI indicates that the interception estimates are too low and well below other global estimates. Lack of observed data for these specific fluxes does not allow us to make further informed conclusions. The conclusions related to NPP are based on the analysis for one irrigation scheme using standard crop coefficients. The estimated yields have the same order of magnitude as the observed yield, but showed larger bias for low yields compared to high yields. This affects the ability of WaPOR to capture the spatial variability of the yield. Thank you for your attention.